Azadeh is implementing a play-based approach in her science units. She has combined two different grade 2 science and technology curriculum strands into several matter discovery stations.
They're both translucent, they're both clear.
So Azadeh's classroom includes a carpeted area for circle time and tables for collaborative work. Each discovery station is inviting, but not cluttered with materials. Some stations provide clues to guide students' exploration. It's okay if students use the materials in a different way, though. Azadeh integrates numeracy into student exploration by providing opportunities for sorting and classifying, counting and measuring. The classroom is well stocked with loose parts, materials that can be used and combined in multiple ways. Play materials are accessible to students. They are stored at student height, where they can be easily retrieved and put away. When researching classroom storage and organization, Azadeh saw a lot of Pinterest photos of attractive wicker baskets, which can be prohibitively expensive. Azadeh uses dollar store baskets and recycled materials, which work just as well. Classroom maintenance is a shared responsibility. Labels and photos assist with tidying and transitions. One of the most important classroom resources is time. Ideally, students have a minimum of 1 hour each day for self-directed exploration. When students are stressed, changes in the brain and body make learning difficult. Azadeh tries to create a safe environment in her classroom where students feel free to explore, contribute ideas, and take reasonable risks. In the past, Azadeh put a lot of time and energy into creating stunning bulletin boards. This year, though, she has chosen to leave her walls almost blank at the beginning of the school year. As the year progresses, the walls fill with a wide range of student work. Instead of curated perfection, Azadeh's classroom walls tell a story of student learning over time.
Hello, welcome. Come on in, sit down on the carpet. Good morning.
Azadeh's classroom is a safe environment for her students, and she shows this by warmly welcoming them as they arrive each day. When students offer ideas, Azadeh paraphrases them without criticism. Students are encouraged to work out disputes on their own before asking for adult intervention. Azadeh models respectful listening and language.
Would you want to sleep in there?
Yeah, and it looks really comfy, super comfy. What about?
Developing the capacity for self-regulation is an important part of a child's emotional development. Azadeh has created a quiet area in her classroom for students who need a break from the busy classroom atmosphere. Up next, learn how to assess student progress in a playful classroom.